Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 9.1, Problem 5. This is Section 9.1, Problem number 5. It says find a 99% confidence interval for a random sample with a mean of 222 and a sample size of 49. Assume that the population standard deviation is known to be 21. So because it's asking for a confidence interval, we're going to use the confidence interval formula, which is x bar plus or minus sigma, the standard deviation, over square root of n, the sample size, times z sub c, the confidence coefficient. That's the formula. So now as you fill it in, x bar, the sample mean is 222. That's given. Plus or minus sigma, the standard deviation, it says that it's 21, over square root of n, n is the size of the sample, so it says sample size is 49, times z sub c, the confidence coefficient. So this problem wants a confidence level of 99%. So you do have a chart where you can look up that 99% has a confidence coefficient of 2.58. So that's how the confidence interval formula fills in. Now to do the math, what you need to deal with first is the square root that we have in the denominator, square root of 49, which I happen to know is 7. 7 times 7 is 49. So the first step of the process, I'm going to write 222 plus or minus 21 over 7 instead of 21 over square root of 49. And I'll leave the rest of the stuff the way it is, like the 2.58 on the end can stay for a minute. And now the next step is to reduce to 21 over 7, which very conveniently reduces to a whole number, which is 3. So I'll have 222 plus or minus 21 over 7, which reduces to 3 times 2.58. Now, what I can do is multiply 3 times 2.58. So my confidence interval is 222 plus or minus 3 times 2.58 is 7.74. And that's what you would call the margin of error. The margin of error is the when you get one number after the plus and minus, that's the margin of error. For this problem, it's 7.74. And now that I have that, I can split this into a separate minus and a separate plus. I like to do the minus first to give me the low end of the interval first. I think it looks nicer that way. So the low end of my interval will be 222 minus 7.74 to the upper end of my interval will be the same number as 222, but this time plus 7.74. So on the low end, when I subtract 222 minus 7.74, it will be 214.26. And the upper end, when I add 222 plus 7.74, it'll be 229.74, and that's our confidence interval. We are reasonably sure that the true population mean is somewhere in that interval between 214.26 and 229.74.